all around the world, Hungary, the Netherlands, America, and people were just firing emails at me. So that was very interesting. And then slowly the video started traveling virally around the world. And so the hate mails, they still continue till now. I've got one just recently. They started changing to love emails, and people were, you know, saying, wow, you know, well, put on your father, put on, you know, he should be able to do whatever he wants. He went through it, it's up to him to dance or not dance or stand on his head or whatever. And anyway, there was a flood of love mails, and then it went through Russia and through Europe and America, and then Australia, then it hit Israel, and so really interesting responses. But and then Germany and the East European countries, and that was really interesting because then suddenly I'm getting these mails about our hearts are open, our hearts have been opened. We laughed, we cried. Thank you. Hate mail. You should have been gassed years ago. I bet this gas bill was expensive. The dirty son of a bitch, a legend will soon become a reality. Fuck your mother. You will not survive the real Holocaust, you fucking Jew. Look at that nose on the cockroach. Goes on the blood mail. Dear Jane, this is truly one of the most prolific videos ever uploaded on YouTube, ever. Thank you. Your father is living proof that the Nazis may have caused him horrific trauma, but they didn't break his spirit. I work at Paramount Studios, Hollywood, New York, and have worked for Universal Studios in the past. While copyright infringement is a crime, the studios rarely follow through with the lawsuit. Anyway, this is about the copyright because it was taken off YouTube after 10 days. DJ, I'm a child of a survivor whose grandparents perished in Auschwitz and also an artist. Humor and joy were the way many survived. I salute you and celebrate you and your family. With you and your family. Invite me as a friend on Facebook. Man, usually I could not be bothered to write to any artist about anything. Your video of your family dancing in a death camp is the exception. I fully support you, I think it's wonderful. I've been to Dachau, not Auschwitz, and understand the difference, of course. That being said, I applaud the video and your father for participating in it. To be honest, I watched it and your video and your family video, and I'm still fighting back tears. This is the absolute essence of life, of joy, of love. It goes on. He said, I am Catholic from the US, not Jewish. If I made this video, I would be ashamed and rightly criticised. However, whatever people say about your motives, who cares? Your father should be able to agree with you. And then it goes on. Healing mail. There's a lot of healing mail. Hi dear Mrs. Foreman, I saw your video this morning and I absolutely loved it. Actually, it did something to the cells in my body that felt like a freeing of memories. I cried of joy. I just wanted to be there and dance with you guys. This is such an important video, one of the only things I've seen that brings a little closure and moving on. Not that things shouldn't be remembered. I don't know how to say it, it's just a real celebration of life and the power of love. Anyway, you get the idea. So that was very interesting for me, the response, and I'm sort of thinking what I can do with it now because it was overwhelming. Like there's probably tens of thousands of emails. And so it's really interesting why a group of Jews dancing at a concentration camp should bring up so much. Bring up so much hate, so much love, so much pain and healing. And you know, it was just random that I did this work. I never expected or imagined the response. Opened up the world to me and opened up the world, and it actually made me see that, you know, there's people who have such a big heart, there's people who really are looking for something to help heal their heart, and there's also people who have a lot of hatred still. And I guess those people, I tried writing to a lot of those people with hatred. I managed to convince one neo-Nazi that I wasn't such a bad Jew. So, what I find the most interesting, that the naivety or the unknowing or whatever it might be that creates people. on other people, the dictatorship of that government, whatever it is, it's still happening today. And I feel like a peace activist, but it's just, that's what's really interesting to see. The hate mail made me realise that, you know, things really haven't changed. I mean, things have changed, but things haven't changed. And with some people, and sometimes it's scary. And sometimes it's scary for me, and that's why I go, just to end up, as Miss World Peace, to lots of hate, I call them hate rallies in Australia, in Melbourne. And I go, you know, trying to actually just show a different way, that not everything's black and white, but there's lots of layers in between, and that, you know, the best thing could be if we can talk to each other if we have difficulty with the other person or somebody who's different to us. Yeah, so it really was an opening to trying to communicate. And I know that it doesn't, you can't really communicate. I think if people have hatred in their heads, I'm still trying to understand this, but it's really hard. Whatever you say, it just hits the wall. And it's like a blindness almost in the eyes. It's really hard to talk, but I haven't given up. So it's really fascinating. You know, as much as I say, what is this heavy thing called the Jew, and I'm obsessed, and how does this get over it, or maybe just get over it? It's just very interesting what it's brought up and what it makes you think about and how it opens up this whole topic to the world. Just the world, it's opened up me as an artist to the world. I didn't mention that not only people that don't like Jews, but also many members of the Jewish community didn't like it. That was very important to say. So some people also write very nasty letters like this deranged artist, Jane Coleman, a mad woman, and they felt very offended because you don't dance on the site of the ashes of millions of people. And I tried to explain, I understand what they're saying, this is my own personal interpretation, and that I don't feel I'm dancing on the site, I don't think I'm dancing on them, I feel that I'm giving them a life. I feel that we're celebrating their life, we're giving respect to them, and hoping that the memory continues for the future. And the beginning of this video, I don't know if you noticed, but we're standing with our heads bent in respect, and in memory, and in, you know, and veil. And my dad just actually suggested that maybe I put a bit of, like, a prayer, a Catholic prayer, in the beginning. But I thought, you know, that might be an idea. And I want to say that it's really wonderful to have my dad here hanging out. We come here nearly every day, and like I said, this video can't be shown if we're not here, because the board of directors was concerned that there'd be problems on either side. And so we come here most days, me and my dad, we trot in, and we sit down, we've made a lounge room. And Dad's really, you know, open to talking. Like, he's great, because he loves talking to people and telling stories, and good stories, and not, you know, bad stories, and the good Nazi, and the bad Nazi, and the good this, and the bad this. You know, a very even, open, forgiving attitude to the world. And it's been great because I think it's a really special opportunity for me.
And he dances.
And he dances.
He's beautiful women.
He grabs beautiful women and he dances. And
so... He's doing dance with me.
Does anyone have any